Hello and welcome to an overview of Integration Studio. Integration Studio is bundled with the OutSystems development suite. It allows you to create extensions to the OutSystems platform through the creation of custom adapters that integrate with existing systems, databases, or custom code. Integration Studio has its own module format that is called an extension module. And that's where developers can build their adapters that are then published to the OutSystems server, thus making whatever functionality your extension has available to the normal modules. Integration Studio's UI is very uncluttered, as you can see on the right-hand side of the slide, and it essentially boils down to the extension's content tree on the left, to which you can add new elements via right-clicking, and the element details section on the right-hand side, where you can then define the properties of the selected element. Let's look into two of the most common scenarios whereby you will want to use Integration Studio to produce an extension. One scenario is importing external database tables to be used in your application as entities. The second scenario is writing custom native code that you will be able to use on your application as actions. The process of importing external database tables is very simple. First, someone will need to declare and detail a database connection inside Service Center. This is not normally the role of a developer, but rather of the systems administrator. The administrator only needs to do this setup once during the configuration of the environment. Then the developer needs to create an extension inside Integration Studio, connect to the OutSystems server where this database connection has been set up, and import the desired tables that are available there. You might want to tweak certain characteristics of the imported module. For example, fine-tuning data types that were inferred wrongly, or add descriptions to the entities and attributes that will be created. It's important to note that these imported external tables don't get their data copied in any shape or form to the local database. In runtime, you'll actually be querying directly over the database connection that was defined. So the steps inside Integration Studio are: you start the wizard, you pick the database and inside which tables you're interested in. They appear in Integration Studio and you can tweak any of the properties of the imported module. And upon publishing on the server, they become visible to your modules. Writing custom native code is also a breeze. You just need to create the extension module in Integration Studio and define whatever actions, together with their inputs and outputs, that you will want to write code for. Then Integration Studio will generate code stubs and the project for you to write using the proper visual environment for the dedicated language. So for the .NET stack of the OutSystems platform, you will use Visual Studio, while for the Java stack of the OutSystems platform, you will use Eclipse. It's important to note that you won't be able to call the Java code from a Microsoft server. Once you finish writing your code using the IDE, the extension will be compiled together with any dependencies that you've added to the project, and it will be published into the server, ready to be available to Service Studio modules. Of course, you're not limited to writing all of the code yourself. For example, if you purchase a third-party assembly, you'll be able to call it from this custom code and use this procedure to include this external resource into your project. Again, the steps are very simple. You start by defining the prototypes of the actions and the underlying structures that you will need to call from your modules. Then you will generate the project that will open on the IDE of the target stack. There, you will flesh out the generated stubs, and upon publishing the extension to the server, this functionality becomes available to your applications. The way to consume any of these functionalities from an extension is similar to the way you've consumed resources from other modules via the Manage Dependencies dialog in Service Studio. And that's Integration Studio in a nutshell. See you in the next lesson.